Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Huawei HCIA Artificial Intelligence Overview Classroom. This chapter will lead us to unveil the mysterious veil of artificial intelligence. We will learn the basic concepts related to artificial intelligence, understanding the history and application scenarios of artificial intelligence. At the same time, it will also introduce Huawei's artificial intelligence development strategy. Finally, he will come to lead everyone to look ahead at the development trends of artificial intelligence. So after all that discussion, what exactly is artificial intelligence? How has it developed to this day? How much can we see the presence of artificial intelligence in real life? With these questions in mind, let's start today's journey into artificial intelligence. So, in terms of understanding channels for artificial intelligence, mainly through news, movies, and some practical applications in life, right? What does artificial intelligence look like in everyone's eyes? Let's take a look here and list some examples. The news went to great lengths to showcase a future prospect of artificial intelligence and some challenges faced by artificial intelligence. At the same time, in the entertainment sector, we can see movies. There are many snippets envisioning the future scenarios of artificial intelligence. Some scenes from early science fiction films shot at the same time. Actually, it is already being applied in our daily lives. For example, technologies like virtual reality and so on. Some applications related to daily life, we will see in entertainment and other scenes, then it generates some applications related to artificial intelligence. We will introduce it to everyone later. Now let's take a look at artificial intelligence from the perspective of research scholars. How do they think? First of all, it was in 1956 when Alan Turing raised questions about performance considerations. Next, researcher John McCarthy, he was in the 1950s, proposed an idea that is about artificial intelligence. The goal is to enable machines to achieve the same behavior. Give humans the same behavior. So Marvin Minsky, further exploring the concept of artificial intelligence, he said artificial intelligence is a science. It enables machines to do what humans need intelligence to do. What is that person's intelligence? Marvin Minsky here raises a question for us. Let's understand what intelligence means. Through this slide, we can see passing through here. We can see the intelligence of human beings. It can be divided into seven categories: language, logic, space, and physical operation, as well as music, interpersonal relationships, and introspection that we are familiar with. Then we will discover the last category. In this realm of introspection, it is a bottleneck that current machines have not yet reached. What is a general definition of artificial intelligence? It's something we can see. It is used for research and development, theoretical approaches for simulating, extending, and expanding human intelligence, a new scientific technology in the field of technology and application systems. Back in 1956, first proposed by John McCarthy, actually in 1956, a conference on artificial intelligence was held at that time. Regarding the content of the meeting, the topic established for discussion by everyone is artificial intelligence. One of the purposes of artificial intelligence, it's actually about enabling machines to think like humans. Let the machine possess human intelligence. So, up to this day, the connotation of artificial intelligence has greatly expanded. From this picture, can see artificial intelligence. It is an interdisciplinary subject. It not only includes our computer science, at the same time, neuroscience, cognitive science, psychology, logic, linguistics, the realm of disciplines like philosophy, EIT, has also been integrated into the field of artificial intelligence. Then we further delve into some core technologies related to artificial intelligence. It covers some technical domains. In this picture, we can see artificial intelligence incorporates our machine learning, data mining, and pattern recognition, calculate, technological fields such as neural computing, and so on. Let's take a look at artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. Among these terms that we often hear, what kind of relationship do they have? In fact, we can intuitively see through this diagram, they are mutually inclusive relationships. Is that correct? The four elements of artificial intelligence requires extra attention from everyone. Here we will see one of the four elements of artificial intelligence, data, algorithm, computing power. Scenarios are essential. So, let's say, data. It provides a constant supply of data for our artificial intelligence. With the advent of the big data era, we will find that the amount of data generated every day, all are very huge. So we need to process some data, then provide us with some relevant algorithms for our artificial intelligence to solve problems in certain scenarios. So here, we just can't do without. In some complex computer programs, requires powerful computational support. So here is the indispensable place for the four essential elements of our artificial intelligence. Specify the specific issues in that scenario. Specific analysis. In that specific scenario, there are specific issues. We need to apply the corresponding algorithm to achieve it. Artificial intelligence, technical learning, deep learning, further discussion of the relevant text between them. Let's just get to know each other. Technical learning. It is specifically dedicated to studying how computers simulate or achieve human learning behavior, to acquire new knowledge or skills, reorganize the existing knowledge structure, continuously improve its own performance. It is one of the core research areas of artificial intelligence. That deep learning originates from our research on artificial neural networks. In fact, artificial neural networks, it is a branch of our machine learning. The multilayer perceptron, it is a deep learning structure of deep learning. Deep learning is a new field in the field of technical learning. It is an extension and expansion in the field of our technical learning. Deep learning refers to mimicking the mechanisms of the human brain. Explain some data. So this data tend to focus on some unstructured data. For example, the images, sounds, and text that we see. With the development of artificial intelligence, we will see that there are different viewpoints in the school of artificial intelligence. First of all, let's introduce the symbolism school here. Their process of understanding this idea. In other words, the cognitive process of human beings is a process of various symbols and reasoning operations. That person is a physical symbol system. Computers are also physical symbol systems. Therefore, computers can be used to simulate human intelligent behavior. Representation of knowledge, knowledge reasoning, and knowledge application is the core of artificial intelligence. Symbolism. It can be considered as knowledge and concepts representing through symbols. So, we see this picture. This example is about the object of an apple in the eyes of symbolism. Some of its descriptions can be obtained through some sources, structures, applying and reasoning with knowledge such as types and so on. At the same time, representations of knowledge such as color, size, shape, and so on describe our apple object. Symbolism, its focus lies in reasoning, symbolic reasoning, and machine reasoning. A typical example is the expert system that we all have heard of. That expert system is a typical representative of our symbolic logic. Next, we will see that with the passage of time, propose the human connectionism. The core idea of connectionism is about the way we think. It is basic, it is a neuron, rather than a process of symbolic processing. So when simulating the mechanisms of our human brain to perform some symbolic processing, we will find that it will have a neuron cell body. Then it has its corresponding dendrites and axons. Axons transmit signals. In this picture, let's take a look at how connectionists describe the concept of an apple in their view. We will find that when the associative object describes this apple, it is represented by various nodes. So these few nodes, they do not have specific meanings. However, on these nodes, it and the corresponding weights can ultimately represent our apple object. So this is when connectionism and symbolic representation describe some objects. The difference between them, the destination, it is manifested in our neural networks and deep learning, which is the connectionism. Next, another school of thought. It is behaviorism. Then we will see the idea of behaviorism. Intelligence depends on perception and action. Our intelligent behavior is a process of reacting and responding through external perception. Here we will find that intelligence does not need representation, does not need knowledge. No need for inference. AI can evolve gradually like human intelligence. Then we will find that the behavior described as intelligent is manifested through continuous interaction with the surrounding environment. Behaviorism, It can be understood that this machine is demonstrating a behavior of continuous trial and error through its own actions. And finally, it is presented. Then we have behaviorism. Its focus is on behavior control in the aspect of adaptive and opportunistic computing evolution. Next, we can learn about some of the persistent developments related to artificial intelligence. Here we meet the familiar time again. In 1956, at that time, in the town of Hanros in the United States, at Dartmouth College, introduced a term for artificial intelligence. At that time, during this meeting, it has been a full 2 months since the start, but no substantial progress has been discussed. So at that time, the discussion at the meeting focused on determining a theme. It's artificial intelligence from then on, after the concept of artificial intelligence was born, has triggered some research by many scholars. We will see this scholar, Arthur Samuel himself, proposed the term learning like this. At the same time, he also developed a chess software. This checkers software can beat him himself. We will see it here. It is an early experimental case study on the learning aspect of artificial intelligence. After that, we will find that after the concept of artificial intelligence was proposed and some goals of its development, that marked the first boom period in the development of artificial intelligence. Then, at that time, we will see that due to some limitations in computing power, the failure of machine translation and some other projects, leading to the development of our artificial intelligence, faced some doubts successively. The development of artificial intelligence has gone through its first trough. Next, we will see that as time passes, many scholars continue to carry out his research. In the early days, he proposed a single-layer perceptron when we talked about artificial intelligence. Can only solve simple problems involving AND or. That does not solve the XOR problem. During the second period of prosperity, we will see a model called multi-layer perceptron has been proposed. With such a model, he can solve the XOR problem that our early single-layer perceptron could not solve, that broke through a limitation. Meanwhile, during this period, decision tree models with stronger adaptability effects have also emerged. We will find that during this period, artificial intelligence is gradually entering its second heyday. During this period, driven by the development of expert systems and fifth-generation computers, around the year 1987, at that time, the LISO market collapsed. At the same time, some regarding the symbolic reasoning about artificial intelligence abstraction gradually encountered a bottleneck. So these in the field of reasoning will no longer receive any more attention. These symbol processing-based models have faced some questioning and opposition. That artificial intelligence experienced another low point in his life. At the same time, we will see that in 1997, another one of its kind, events in competitive games, this news has once again attracted people's attention. That's 1997. A chess software developed by IBM called Deep Blue, defeating the then world chess champion Kasparov. After that year, technologies related to some applications of artificial intelligence once again entered the public's field of vision. We will see that with the occurrence of this event, in the future time nodes, the improvement in computing performance and our current internet technology, with the rapid development of the mobile internet, our artificial intelligence is gradually improving, entered into some one of his flourishing periods. Now, let's take a look at the timeline here. In 2006, Professor Hinton and his students, the artificial intelligence has already begun some research on deep learning. At that time, actually, just some research on learning algorithms. Regarding this deep learning, specific scenarios he can apply to, there are quite a few, the path of exploration. At that time, it was in the exploratory stage. If we focus on research in the field of image, we will find that in 2012, there is one. In a competition like ImageNet for image classification, in image classification competitions, traditional image classification algorithms will be found unable to classify our images well. Deep learning, the performance of our image classification can be improved by many percentage points. At this moment, deep learning is gradually entering the research field of academia. With that, the arrival of the big data era in 10 years. So, as we know, deep learning requires a very large amount of data supply. At this moment, the amount of data can ensure some of our artificial intelligence. The relevant algorithms can be implemented and put into practice. Some subsequent applications related to artificial intelligence emerged. For example, the voice assistant used in our smartphones. More and more applications related to AI artificial intelligence are emerging, also present in the terminals of smartphones. So here, it is the data algorithm and computing power among the four elements of our artificial intelligence. Their mutual support and the practical scenarios we eventually apply are demonstrated that can see our artificial intelligence related applications in the vigorous development. So here, there is a very famous event. It was in 2016. AlphaGo defeated the world's Go champion, Lee Sedol. So at that time, after this news broke, there are many voices about artificial intelligence, believe in artificial intelligence. There are also those who are pessimistic about artificial intelligence. So here, the technology used in this, in our artificial intelligence, what we see is deep learning. Deep learning applied in a system like our AlphaGo. In competitive board games, we will see in the end the most powerful version of this AlphaGo. He actually used it among the three major philosophical schools that we just introduced. Behaviorism, the pattern they advocate about perceiving actions. The technique used inside is reinforcement learning.